Hello, good afternoon, ma'am. I am P. Kavita. I am working as a contract lecturer in mathematics. Today I will teach first MSc statistics paper 1, that is linear algebra. In that linear algebra, we will explain unit 2. Unit 2, I will share the screen. Hello, my screen visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, continuation. Yesterday we have told the definition of field. Field, that is, F is satisfying 11 conditions, then we say that F is a field. After that, today we define definition of vector. We define vector, that is the definition of vector. An ordered set of n numbers is called an n vector. Ordered set of n numbers, that is called an n vector. N is called order of a vector. N is called order of a vector. J. We are denoting vector as J. That is looking like vector. We are denoting that is called as a J. N numbers are called components of elements of the vector. Now we are defining vector. Vector is represented by J. The ordered set of n numbers is called an n vector, and n is called the order of a vector J. N numbers are called components of elements of the vector. Example, let J equal to, that is ordered set of n numbers, x1, x2 and so on, xn. If it is two numbers, that is that is called as an ordered pair, x1, x2. Therefore, we are having n numbers, ordered set of n numbers, that is J equal to x1, x2 and so on, xn. J is an n vector with components x1, x2 and so on, xn. We are denoting J is x1, x2 and so on, xn. Is an n vector with components x1, x2 and so on, xn. Next, the n components may be written in either in horizontal or vertical line. N components are x1, x2 and so on, xn. That can be written in a horizontal line or vertical line. Accordingly, the vector is called row vector or column vector. The n components may be written in a horizontal line. Then that is the row vector, or it can be written in a column wise vertical line. Then we say that is the column vector. Next, a vector, if all its elements are equal to the 2 mari, instead of by you have to write 2. A vector, if all its elements are equal to 0, that is called a null vector. A null vector means all elements are zeros, then we say that a vector is a null vector, and is derived by O. This is not correct, and it is denoted by O, and it is denoted by O. You have to write, and the vectors e1 is 1 0 0 0 and so on, 0 n terms. Next, e2 is 0 1 0 0 and so on, 0 and so on, en is equal to 0, 0, 0 and so on, 1, are called elementary vector or unit vector. Already you have studied in the vector space and linear transformations basis, that is e1, 1, 0, 0, e2, 0, 1, 0. Therefore, these are called elementary vectors or unit vectors. e1 is 1, 0, 0, 0 and so on, 0 n terms. E2 is 0, 1, 0, 0 and so on, 0. E and so on, En is 0, 0, 0 and so on, 1 are called elementary vector or unit vectors. Next, The vector j is defined over a field F. The vector is denoting by j. The vector j is defined over a field F if all its components belongs to F. If all the components belongs to F, then the vector j is defined over a field F. The field F may be real or complex. Accordingly, j will be real or complex. J will be real or complex, then F may be accordingly real or complex. It is J is real, then F is also real. F may be real or complex, accordingly J will be real or complex. If J is real, then field F is also real. If J is complex, then F is also complex. Next, consider P n vectors. We are considering n vectors. We are denoting vector as j I, j ki suffix I ma, j ki suffix I, that is x1 power I ma, x1 power I, that is x2 power I, and so on, xn power I. Therefore, I equal to 1, 2, and so on, p. Consider p n vectors annamo. Consider p n vectors, that is x1 I, x2 I, and so on, xn I. If I equal to 1 means j1. J1 can be written as ji is x1, I, x2, I, and so on, xn, I. If let us take I equal to 1, then we will write ji1. Ji1 is x1, 1, x2, 1, and so on, xn, 1. If I is 2, ji2, ji2 is x2, 1, x1, 2, x2, 2, and so on, xn, 2. Similarly, ji is n, I is p, then jp is equal to x1 power p, x2 power p, and so on, xn power p. That is, you have to write. Now, the components of these pn vectors form p by n matrix. The components of these pn vectors form p by n matrix, capital X, as capital X is equal to j1, j2, and so on, jp. Therefore, its value is equal to j1 is the matrix x1 I, x2 I, and so on. My, this is not correct. J1 is, in place of I, we have to substitute 1. That is x1 1, x2 1, and so on, xn 1. You have to write there in place of j1, x1 1. It is seeing I, therefore, you have to write x11, x21, and so on, xn1. First row is wrong. Next, second row, x1 in place of I2, that is x12, x22, and so on, xn2 is correct. Next, similarly, j3. Next, last row, jp is also wrong. Jp is x in place of I, we are substituting p, that is x1p. We have to write x1p, x2p, and so on, x and p. That one is correct. Last row wrongly written, which is x1p, x2p, and so on, x and p. Next, vectors in R2, dimension R2, that is, vectors in R2, the set of all vectors with two entries. R2 means two elements, so that is, dimension is two. Therefore, the set of all vectors with two entries is denoted by R2. R stands for real numbers and the exponent 2 stands for that the vectors contains two entries or components or elements. Two entries are entries and anachu or components or elements. R2 means R stands for real numbers and exponent 2 stands for vectors. We are having two entries or two components or two elements. Therefore, example is 2, 3 in the two elements, therefore R2 which is. Similarly, capital V is also two elements, 1, 5, that is a vector. Similarly, capital W is W1, W2. This is also two elements, that is two entries or two components. Vector in R2 is this. Two vectors in R2 are equal if their corresponding entries are equal. Let us take any two vectors. That is 2, 3. Another one is 2, 3. The corresponding entries. First two element 2. next vector kuda first element 2, that is 2 2 and first second element 3, next vector lo second element 3 aithe, then those two are same, those two are equal antam. Those two vectors, that is two vectors in R2 are equal if their corresponding entries are equal. Any two vectors, their corresponding entries are equal, then we say that the two vectors are equal. The vectors in R2 are ordered pairs of real numbers. Vectors in R2 can be written as, that is ordered pair of real numbers. Given two vectors U and V in R2. In R2, we have given U and V are two vectors. Their sum is, vector U plus V. U is one vector and V is one vector. Their sum of these two vectors is U plus V is obtained by adding the corresponding entries in U and V. In U, the two vectors U and V are given. Their sum U plus V we have to calculate. That is obtained from the corresponding entries in U and V. In U, first letter, first element. In V also first element we will add, then we will get U plus V. Similarly, second element in U, second element in V, we have to add. Next, example 1, 2. One vector is 1, 2 plus another vector is, let us take U vector is 1 minus 2, V vector is 2, 5. Then U plus V, it will comes 1 plus 2 minus 2 plus 5. Therefore, its value is 1 plus 2 is 3, minus 2 plus 5 also 3. Therefore, given a vector U, this is the example of summation of two vectors. Next, given a vector U and a scalar C, the product vector C into U is obtained by multiplying each entry in U with C. The product vector CU is obtained from, first take any vector U and take any scalar C. Scalar C, that means that must be some constant. Therefore, now we are calculating the product vector CU, C into U, that is obtained by multiplying each entry in U with C. C into U, C is a scalar, then multiplying each element in U with C, then we will get C into U. Example, if U is 2, 3, in R2, U is 2, 3, therefore C equal to, let us take C is 4, then C into U. C into U can be written as C value is 4, U is 2, 3. Now we are multiplying C into U1, C into U1, C into U2. Therefore, 4 into 2 is 8, 4 into 3 is 12. We will get CU value is 8 to 12. This is vector. CU value is vector, that is 8 into 12. For convenience, sometimes we write a column vector 3, 1. 3, 1 as 3 comma minus 1. Column vector 3, 1, we will write an ordered pair 3 comma minus 1. 3, 1, 3, comma, 3 minus 1 or 3 comma 1. In this case, we use parentheses and commas to distinguish the vector 3 comma minus 1 from a row matrix 3 minus 1. Konchu space undal, row matrix 3 minus 1. We are representing as row matrix 3, 1. We are representing this as a vector 3 comma minus 1. Is there a... Do you know the difference between the vector and matrix? Matrix is if row vector 3, 1 and first row, first element 3, second element minus 1. That we are denoting as vector 3 comma minus 1. Next, graphical representation of vector. Graphical representation of vector, an entity having both magnitude and direction is called a vector. This is, we know that a vector is a physical quantity which is having both magnitude and direction. Therefore, an entity having both magnitude and direction is called a vector. Next, a vector may be represented as an arrow starting from origin. We are representing the vector as an arrow starting from origin. See below the picture. Three dimensional space, that is first two dimensional space, that is x axis and y axis. O is the origin. Now we are representing A1, A2. A1, A2 is, we are representing as a point. that is a1, a2. Some 2, comma 3, 2 is on x-axis and 3 is on y-axis, then it will represent as a point in a graph 2, comma 3. Therefore, a1, a vector may be represented as an arrow starting from origin. Starting from origin O, that is to a1 comma a2. Next, and proceeding to the point x1, x2 and so on xn, the coordinates x1, x2 and so on xn are called components of the vector. Now, we could a1, a2, and that is the vector that we are representing as a point. Then components are a1, a2. We could n components. A vector may be represented as an arrow starting from origin and proceeding to the point. The point is x1, x2 and so on xn. The coordinates x1, x2 and so on xn are called the components of the vector. Next, a vector in the space which is represented by two coordinates, is called two-component vector. Similarly, a vector in the space which is denoted by three coordinates. First figure two components, vector. Second figure three components, that is three component vectors. First one, a vector in the space which is represented by the two coordinates only. A vector which is represented by the two coordinates is called the two component vector. Similarly, a vector in the space which is denoted by the three coordinates is called three component vectors. See that figure on x-axis and y-axis from the origin to arrow we are having, that is the point a1, a2, that is the vector we are representing as a point a1, a2, only two components, two coordinates. Next, another figure is three-dimensional space, that is three axes x, y, z, and all the three are perpendicular to one another. Now we are representing the a1, a2, a3 point, that is also from origin O, that is a1, a2, a3 vector, three components vector. This is the graphical representation of vector. We'll go to next document. Is the screen sharing? Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Next. R2 is the set of all points in the two-dimensional components. R2 is the set of all points in the two-dimensional coordinate space. Next. The geometric visualization of a vector, say, 3 minus 1, is represented as an arrow from the origin to the point. Once again, R2 is the set of all points in the two-dimensional coordinate space. R2 is dimension 2. If it is R3, it is dimension 3. R2 is the set of all points in the two-dimensional coordinate space. Next, the geometric visualization of a vector, say 3 minus 1. Our vector is 3 minus 1. We are representing as a geometrically, that is represented as an arrow from the origin, which is representing as an arrow from the origin to the point 3 comma minus 1. To the point 3 comma minus 1, point x comma y means x value is 3, y value is minus 1. Similarly, point 3 comma minus 1, that is example, represent the vectors 2 comma 2, minus 4 comma minus 1 and 3 comma minus 1 in graph. We know the graph. Hello? All of you know the graph, that is x-axis, right side positive x-axis, left side negative x-axis, and above the line positive y-axis, and below the line negative y-axis. We know the quadrants, four quadrants. In first quadrant, x is positive and y is positive. And in second quadrant, x is negative, y is positive, that is minus 4 value. Next, in third quadrant, x value is negative and y value is also negative. In fourth quadrant, x value is positive but y value is negative. Now we are representing the vectors 2 minus 2, sorry, 2 2 only, 2 2, minus 4 minus 1 and 3 minus 1 in graph. In graph, 2 2 means x value 2, y value 2, which lies in the which quadrant, ma? Please respond. 2 2 and a which lies in which quadrant? X value 2, y value 2, it lies in which quadrant? We are having 4 quadrants. Emma?
Second quadrant, ma'am.
First quadrant is 0 to 90, second quadrant is 90 to 180, third is 180 to 270, fourth is 270 to 360. Complete angle. First quadrant is 0 to 90, get a positive x is positive, y is positive. Therefore, 2 comma 2 lies in the first quadrant. X value 2, y value 2, that is, this was shown in the graph. That is, x is 2 comma 2. Similarly, minus 4 comma minus 1. Minus 4 comma minus 1, x value is minus 4, y value also minus 4. Which lies in which quadrant? Minus 4, minus 1, no? X negative, y good negative.
Third quadrant. Third quadrant, ma'am.
Not audible, ma'am. Speak loud.
Third quadrant, ma'am. Third quadrant.
Third x negative, y negative, that is minus 4, minus 1. X value minus 4, y value minus 1. Similarly, 3 minus 1. 3 minus 1 means x value plus 3, y value minus 1. It lies in fourth quadrant. That is x is 3 minus 1. We are representing the vectors in graphically as a points. Next. Similarly, this is vectors as points. Now, vectors as arrows. Arrows is starting from origin only. Now 2 2 point 2. In figure also, in first quadrant that point must be 2 2. First quadrant that point must be 2 2. The wrongly written, that is 3 minus 1. Next, second quadrant, third quadrant minus 4 minus 1, correct. Fourth quadrant 3 minus 1, correct. You have to correct this as in first quadrant 2 comma 2. Therefore, vectors as points, I think point 2 we are denoting. The vectors as arrows, I think, that is starting from origin, no? That is O to 3 minus 1 point, we have to draw arrow mark. This is the graphical representation of vectors. Now, sum of two vectors. Let u equal to vector is 2, 2 and v is minus 6, 1. Then u plus v can be written as sum of these two vectors. So, first two letters, first two elements, so that is 2. U plus v can be written as 2, 2 plus v is minus 6, 1. That is 2 minus 6. First letters we are adding. 2 minus 6 is minus 4. Similarly, 2 plus 1. Second coordinates level. Second, 2 plus 1, that is 3. Minus 4, 3, which is the u plus v. This is the sum of the two vectors. U plus v value is minus 4, 3 we have got. Next, parallelogram rule for addition. In addition of two parallelogram law, use you parallelogram law for addition. If u and v in R2, u is one vector in R2, two-dimensional space, and v is also another vector in two-dimensional space, represented as the points in the plane. U and v are vectors, we are representing that are points in the plane. Then u plus v corresponds the fourth vertex of the parallelogram. U and v are representing as a points, then u plus v corresponds the fourth vertex of the parallelogram. Other three vertices are u, o and v. U is u vector and v is another vector, o is the origin. Now see this, u is 2 2 point which lies in second quadrant. First quadrant, u is 2 2, x value 2, y value 2. Similarly, next value minus 4 3 next vector minus 4 3 that is addition of these two vectors are minus 4 no no a vector third vector minus 6 1 we are adding these two first vector u 2 2 are which lies in the first quadrant second vector minus 6 1 are which lies in the second quadrant that is x value is minus 6 y value is 1 now we are adding these two vectors we will draw this minus 6 plus 2 means its value is minus 4 1 plus 2 value is 3 already we have taken example in the above example that u is 2 2 v is minus 6 1 therefore u is on first quadrant v is on second quadrant then u plus v becomes already we have calculated its value is minus 4 3 then now we are representing minus 4 3 as another fourth vertex then first two vertexes are zero second u 2 2 and third vertex so minus 6 1 now fourth vertex summation of u and v is minus 4 3 this look like a parallelogram see that figure joining o u mana remaining point minus 4 3 minus 6 1 no if we are joining the all the four points we have got a parallelogram which is in the parallelogram shape therefore this is the parallelogram rule for addition of two vectors we will get it will forms parallelogram starting vector is origin next note the set of all scalar multiples of a vector is in a line through origin set of all scalar multiples of a vector which is in a line through origin that is line is passing through the origin example if u is 2 minus 1 if u value is 2 minus 1 then display the vectors u 2 u 3 u value we know that the vector is 2 minus 1 and another value 2u 2u is which is 2 is the scalar u is vector scalar multiplication of vector similarly 2u can be written as 2u value what is the value of 2u u is 2 minus 1 then 2u value equal to respond 2 into u ma 2 into u ante 2 into u value 2 minus 1 therefore 2u value is 2 into 2 is 4 2 into minus 1 is minus 2 therefore 2u value is minus 4 2 next similarly 3u value is 3 into u value u is 2 minus 1 therefore 3 into 2 and 6 3 into minus 1 and minus 3 now we are representing u value is 2 minus 1 that is x value is 2 y value is minus 1 we are drawing some point in fourth quadrant next similarly 4 comma minus 2 that is x value is minus 2 y value x value is 4 y value is minus 2 that is also we are representing as a point in fourth quadrant similarly 3u is 6 minus 3 x is 6 y is minus 3 that is also we are representing in graph in the fourth quadrant that is 2 minus 1 is one point next 4 minus 2 is another point next 6 minus 3 is another point now we are adding this line these all the three points we will get a line therefore which is the set of all scalar multiples of a vectors is in a line through origin this line is passing through origin therefore that is symbolically we have written next these are the vectors in R2 means two dimensional space next vectors in R cube is three dimensional space that is vectors in R cube vectors in R cube are 3 by 1 column. 3 by 1, that is not 3 by 1. 3 by 1 ka, which is a order of 3 by 1 log. That is vectors in R cube are 3 by 1 column matrix, column matrices with 3 elements, entries. They are represented geometrically by points in a 3-dimensional coordinate space. R3 is vectors in R3, that is dimension is 3, that can be represented as a column matrix in 3 elements. They are represented geometrically by the points in a 3-dimensional space, in a 3-dimensional coordinate space or space with arrows from the origin. Similarly, what way we have written in the vector in R2, that is representing in the point as a graph, and when the that we are representing vector as in arrows. Similarly, in vectors in R cube also, we are representing the point as a 3-dimensional space and arrows from the origin. Now, example, the vectors A equal to 2, 3, 4. This is a look like a matrix 2, 3, 4, that is 3 by 1. 3 rows, 1 column. And A is 2, 3, 4, and 2A equal to 4, 6, 8. Because A is 2, 3, 4, 2A is 2 into 2 is 4, 2 into 3 is 6, 2 into 4 is 8. That is displayed as, are the vectors A value and 2A value are displayed as follows. Already this is written XYZ axis. XYZ axis, or it can be written X1, X2, X3 axis. Here written x1, x2, x3, or it may be right third x, y, z axis also. In vector, we are representing x1, x2, x3. Now, A is 2, A matrix is x1 is 2, x3 is 3, x2 is 3, x3 is 4. Now, we are representing in x1 axis point x1, that is 2. In x2 axis point 3, in x3 4, we have written the graph in this way. Similarly, 2a is 4 6 8, that can be represented as right side figure. Next, vectors in R power n, if n is a positive integer, n is a positive integer, R power n, read as R power n, R power n, read as R power n, vectors in R power n means dimension is n, the n terms. If n is a positive integer means, what is integers, ma? What are integers? Can anyone respond? Integers, ma. Yesterday also I have told rational numbers, integers. What are integers?
Numbers without
decimal. 0 to.
Zero?
0 to and so on. Starting from 0.
Negative values, minus infinity to infinity together, 0 plus or minus 1 plus or minus 2 and so on, infinity. Yes, that integers. Plus 1 plus 2 plus 3 and so on infinity is positive integers, and then minus 1 minus 2 and so on minus infinity are negative integers. Now we are taking n is a positive integer, and n is a positive integer, that is 1 2 3 and so on, no 0, no negative numbers. N is a positive integer, R power n read as R power n. N is a positive integer, R power n, denotes the correction of all vectors with n entries, usually written as n by 1 column matrices. Vectors in R power n can be represented as n by 1 column matrices, which means n rows and 1 column, that is a n rows 1 column, that is x1, x2 and so on column wise, look like n rows but one column. This is the vectors in R power n. N is the positive integer. Now, span of V or span of U comma V. Span of V and span of U comma V. We know that linear span, ma. Already we have studied in vector space in degree level. Now, span of V and span of U comma V we are defining. Let V be a non-zero vector in R cube. In R cube means dimension. What is the dimension, ma? R cube means?
Three dimension.
Emma? R cube means what is the dimension? How many elements?
Three dimension x, y, and z.
Hello? Let V be a non-zero vector in R cube. R cube means dimension is R cube means dimension is 3, ma. Next, when span V is the set of all scalar multiples of V. Span V is the set of all scalar multiples of V. And we visualize it as a set of points in the line in R cube. Span V is the set of all scalar multiples of V. And we visualize it as a set of points in the line in R cube through V and O. Ma, understood? Let V be a non-zero vector in R cube, that is in three-dimensional space. When span V is the set of all scalar multiples of V. Span V is set of all scalar multiples of V. And we visualize it as a set of points in the line. By seeing like a points in the line in R cube through V and O. Next, if U and V are non-zero vectors in R cube, U and V are non-zero vectors. What is the zero vector means? All elements are zeros. Now, U is non-zero vector and V is also non-zero vector in R cube with V not a multiple of U. V is not a multiple of U that is given. Then span of U comma V is, span of U comma V is a plane in R cube that contains U comma V and O. Span of U comma V is the plane in R cube that contains U, V and O origin. In particular, span of V comma U contains the line in R cube through U and O and the line through V and O. See here. In particular, span of V comma U contains, span of V comma U contains the line in R cube through V and O. First V comma U, span of V comma U ante, which is the line through V and O and the line through U and the line through, sorry, which is first two, which contains the line in R cube through U and O and the line through V and O. That is span of U comma V. Next, this can be represented as a in figure like this, x1, x2, x3, that is a span of V from the origin, V and O, this we are writing, span of V and U. Next, span of U comma V. Span of U comma V is x1, y1, y2, we are denoting left to one value is here, that is U. 2U, 3U, and so on, 4U, 5U lines. Next, 1V, 2V, 3V lines. Lines are crossing like this. That is span of U comma V. We can write. Next. Addition of two vectors. Addition of two vectors is, the addition of two vectors of same order is a vector whose components are obtained by adding their corresponding components. The two vectors add chestuna, that is addition of two vectors we obtain, where that is the addition of two vectors of same order. At each vector of same order, which is we have to every vector which is of same order, then only we will adding those two vectors. The addition of two vectors of same order is a vector whose components are obtained by adding their corresponding components, that is in one vector xi1 and another vector xi2, first component x11, xi2 lo first component x12, we are adding xi is, xi1 is one vector, that is x11, x21 and so on, xn1. Similarly, xi2 is another vector, that is x12, I value is 2, I think, x12, x22 and so on, xn2. Then, xi is equal to xi1 plus xi2, where xi equal to addition of two vectors, xi1 plus xi2, you have to write. And by seeing there is comma, but which is in, but it must be xi1 plus xi2. Xi equal to xi1 plus xi2, that is x1 power 1 plus x1 power 2, comma x2 power 1 plus x2 power 2. We are adding xi1 and xi2, same components, corresponding components we are adding. Similarly, last term, xn1 plus xn2. This is the addition of two vectors. Similarly, product of two vectors. Product of two vectors is we are multiplying two vectors. You have to observe this carefully. Addition of two vectors, we are adding same corresponding vector components. We will get first component, that is x11, x21, x12. Next, x21, x22, same, we are adding. But in multiplication, you have to observe seriously, that is xi1 into xi2, product of two vectors, xi1 into xi2 is first vector, first component x11 into second vector, first component x12, product of two vectors, product of matrices, we are applying product of two vectors. Therefore, xi1 and xi2 is first vector, first component x11 into second vector, first component x12 plus first vector, first component x21, first vector in xi1 is x11. First vector xi1, first component is x11. Similarly, xi2 second vector first component is x12. Those two are multiplying, that is x11 1 x11 x12, first from xi1, second from xi2. Similarly, x21 into x22, first from xi1, second from xi2, plus and so on, xn1 first one from xi1 and xn2 first second one from xi2. Therefore, xi1 into xi2, all the n terms we are having, that is x11, x12, x21, x22, and so on, xn1, xn2. All these terms we are writing as summation. You have to remember this much. Xi1 into xi2, that is the product of two vectors value is, xi1 into xi2, xi1 into xi2 value is, summation I equal to 1 to n, xi power 1 into xi power 2 level, where I equal to 1, 2, 3 and so on n. Let us take I equal to 1, that is x11, x12, that is first term we are having in the above equation, xi1, xi2. If it is take I equal to 2, that is x21, x22, that is in the above equation, that is the second term. In general, last term, xn1, xn1, that is the last term, its value is xn1. All the n terms we are writing as summation, xi1 into xi2 is summation I equal to 1 to n, xi1, xi2, where I equal to 1 to and so on, n. Okay, I will stop here. Today, tomorrow Sunday, Monday, I will explain the remaining topics, that is the inner product. Already you have studied in inner product also in degree level, just to see. Next, length of the vector. Already I have taken in yesterday problem, length of the vector. This formula is, this is norm B. We'll explain next class. I will stop. Please wait for 1 minute. హలో మా రికార్డింగ్ స్టాప్ చేశాను. మీరు ఏమన్నా మాట్లాడారంటే మాట్లాడండి. ఏమ్మా సిలబస్ ఈ వీక్లో అయిపించుకోమన్నారు ఈ వీకెండ్కి. ఈ వీకెండ్ అంటే ఈరోజే కదా, మళ్ళా ఛాన్స్ ఇచ్చారు నెక్స్ట్ వీక్లో చెప్పుకోమన్నట్టుగా. బట్ ఒక 2-3 డేస్లో కంప్లీట్ చేద్దాం సిలబస్. మీకు నెక్స్ట్ వీక్లో ఏమైనా, అదే ఈ నెక్స్ట్ వీక్ తర్వాత ఏమైనా ఎగ్జామ్స్ డిక్లేర్ చేస్తారో, లేదు 21st నుంచి సెకండ్ సెమ్ క్లాస్ చెప్పుకోమన్నారమ్మ. అంటే పీజీ వాళ్ళకి కానీ డిగ్రీ వాళ్ళకి కానీ 21st జూన్ నుంచి సెకండ్ సెమిస్టర్కి క్లాసెస్ స్టార్ట్ చేయమన్నారు. ఆ లోపల ఎగ్జామ్స్ పెడతారా లేదు తర్వాత క్లాసెస్ స్టార్ట్ చేసి తర్వాత పెడతారా అనేది క్లారిటీ ఇవ్వలేదు. కాబట్టి మీరు ఆ లోపల ఈ సిలబస్ అంతా చదువుకోండి, ఒకవేళ ఎగ్జామ్స్ ఏదైనా అనౌన్స్ చేస్తే రాస్తారు. లేదు సెకండ్ సెమ్ సిలబస్ స్టార్ట్ చేసి మధ్యలో పెడతారంటే పెట్టచ్చు. డిగ్రీ ఫైనల్ ఇయర్ వాళ్ళకు మాత్రము జూలై లాస్ట్ వీక్ కానీ ఆగస్ట్ 1st వీక్ కానీ సెమెంట్ ఎగ్జామ్స్ పెడతామన్నారు. మీకు ఇప్పుడే పెట్టేస్తారేమో మరి. ఓకే సరే, లెఫ్ట్ అవుతారా?
ఓకే మ్యామ్.